Welcome back to Intergalactic Forms, a tutorial series inspired by science fiction and space exploration. My name is Blake Rizzo, and I will be your intergalactic tour guide today. Last time, we learned how to make a galaxy and reveal it as a hologram. This time, we're going to be diving into how to create the spaceship interior with Red Giant Geo. We're going to be creating procedural shaders, building textures in After Effects, and it's going to be a blast. Let's dive right in. Okay, hello. Let's go ahead and get our scene set up. We're going to create a new composition. We're going to call this Spaceship. Nice. And go ahead and make the resolution whatever you want. I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. 10 seconds will be fine. We're going to go ahead and create a new solid. We're going to start to bring in Geo here. I'm going to call this Geo. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and navigate over to the Effects and Presets panel. As you can see, if we take a look kind of along this menu here, Red Giant has organized their effects into different folders. You'll see that there's Red Giant Blurs and Glows, Red Giant Color, Distortions, Generators, Motion Graphics. This is to kind of help you to kind of like categorize their effects based off use case. So we're going to go ahead and look for Particles in 3D because Geo is a 3D plugin. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And look at that. Geo's right there, as well as Horizon, Lux, Mir, Tau. So I'm going to go ahead and bring in Geo and then apply it to my layer. And look at that. Okay, so right off the bat, Geo creates this sphere for us. And as you can tell, it's a fully 3D sphere. If I go over to geometry, I can move this around in 3D space. It can go on X, Y, or Z. I can create a null, which allows me to use this null object to move around. Sometimes it's a little bit easier to do that. I'm going to go ahead and undo, unlink null. I also can rotate it, scale it up. Okay, so let's go ahead and bring in our spaceship interior. I can choose my model, and you see that there's a huge library of different models for you to play around with. Okay, so we're going to bring in my spaceship that I made, but if you want to bring in your own spaceship model, you can go ahead and click on this little arrow key right here. This is where you can bring in your model. It takes in .obj files. Hello, this is Editor Blake from the future. Geo also accepts supported formats such as C4D, FBX, GLB, GLTF, DAE, and 3DS. So make sure to try out all those formats in Geo today. You'll be able to bring this into Geo and have the flexibility of messing around with your model in After Effects. Let's go ahead and bring in my model. I'm going to use the cockpit, which is my spaceship cockpit that I made. I'm going to go ahead and hit apply. And check this out. This is the cockpit of my spaceship. I'm going to go ahead and quickly set this up. I'm going to rotate this negative 90. Boop. I'm going to scale this up. Nice. I'm also going to create a new camera, right click, create new camera. I'm going to go ahead and do a one node camera. I'm going to make it 24 millimeter. That's kind of a little bit wider. Maybe 20 millimeter might be good. I'm going to go ahead and hit okay. And now check it out. If I go to my little camera controls by clicking on this dolly towards cursor tool, kind of dolly out a little bit, we can see that we are kind of like inside the cockpit here, which is pretty fun. Okay, so our spaceship interior is looking gray and lifeless. Let's add some color. Let's dive into the materials tab here. This is where we're going to spend the most of this tutorial. As you can see, Geo has 5 materials. And if we click open the material tab, we can see that Geo uses physically based shaders to render what the objects look like. So I made this shader toy to kind of demonstrate what's going on under the hood here. You can see that there's these different maps that decide what the object looks like. This is what a physically based shader does. It uses all these different maps, base color, roughness, mellowness, subsurface, transmission, opacity, emission, bump map, to basically decide what the surface of the object looks like. So let's go ahead and play around here. If I change the base color to, let's make it red, you can see that, okay, now the surface turns red. Roughness, if that's set at 0 right now, 0 and black are kind of associated together. If I bring this up to 100, it's now white. So a white texture, but wait, hold on a second. The highlights disappeared. Okay, well, 0. Okay, that's highlight. So the more rough the object is, the more diffused or matte the highlight is. You can see that. So essentially, if a roughness texture would be fully white, it would be, you wouldn't see it that much. Metalness. Okay, so 0, 100. Okay, wow. So it becomes like a chrome ornament. the more metal it becomes. That makes sense, right? So a texture with black would be no metalness at all. So you can kind of mix these together. Subsurface is great for plants or things where light is kind of entering and bouncing around. A great example of this is skin or plants, anything where light kind of enters in through a surface, bounces around, so light can kind of transmit through the surface. Let's try transmission. What does that do? Okay, transmission's like glass. It's like light can actually transmit through the material. Opacity, okay, that's like a ghost. You can make that, see that 0 is black, 100 is white. And then emission, that's when we start glowing. So if I have this glow green, you can see the entire ball glows green. Bump maps are wild. You can see on this shader of rocky terrain that bump maps create the illusion of bumps on a surface. You can also see on a material like this that it's a combination of several different texture maps that create the look of a certain surface. Let's go ahead and dive back into our spaceship. Okay, welcome back to our spaceship. Let's go ahead and open up materials tab on Geo. We're going to go to material M1, and I always like to just test out which material's which here. So let's see, I'm going to make this red. Okay, this appears to be the glowing emission trim around the spaceship. So I'm going to go ahead and make this white, and we're going to go down to emission color map. We're going to set this to white, maybe a bluish white. I always like to do like a little bit of blue in there. And now you can see that the spaceship has some glowing emission on its nice little trim lighting. Looks great. All right, now let's go see what material 2 is. Material 2, I always like to change the color. Okay, so this is the glass. Okay, so there's these great surface presets here that give us some great results right off the bat. There's one called clear glass. Well, amazing, we're making clear glass. Nice, this looks great. Looks like it already sets the settings for us. Metalness set to 90, transmission set to 90. Opacity. Well, we're actually going to turn opacity down because I want it to be a little bit transparent. Because now if we turn on the transparency grid, we can see that this is a little transparent and we will be able to see stars, or, you know, we'll be essentially be able to see out the window. Very cool. Okay, material 2. Let's move on to material 3. Okay, I always like to see, okay, which one is this? Okay, so this is the Holodesk. Okay, so let's start building the shader for the Holodesk. So I'm going to be creating the texture of the Holodesk with another layer. I'm going to go new solid, and I'm going to type this Holodesk base color. Nice. And I'm going to hide it. Okay, so let's go to Geo, and underneath base color map, we're going to set base color map to Holodesk base color, and we're going to set this to effects and masks. And now if we apply an effect, so let's go over to effects and presets. I'm going to type in fractal noise and then apply it onto our layer here. You'll see that the effects that we apply onto this Holodesk base color now start to texture the Holodesk itself. The red's still coloring it, so I'll bring it back to white. But now check this out. If I start playing around with this texture with on the fractal noise, it will live update on the Holodesk, which is pretty freaking cool. One thing we might see as we're messing around with our texture is this little line here, and it's called a seam, a UV seam. A UV seam can be identified if the texture doesn't cleanly blend. This is actually like, think of this like the edge of the paper. UVs tell a 2D texture how to map around a 3D object. If you see a seam, that means the edge of your texture is not cleanly overlapping with the other side of your texture. Now we can fix this in one or two ways. One, we can go into the 3D program of our choice that we built the model in and then adjust the UVs in there. Or we can go to the texture settings underneath M3 or whatever the material you're working in. There's this texture tiling control here. If I start adjusting it, it starts adjusting the texture density of the texture itself. I'm going to adjust this to, I think I found it to work with this one. It's like 319. Look at that. The seam kind of goes away. However, this is kind of a band-aid fix. What we could do is we should actually probably go into our 3D model and adjust the seams, but I just wanted to show you that cool technique. For the Holodesk, I wanted to create like an ancient boxy pattern. So I'm going to set the noise type to block, and that changes the kind of these turns this blocky pattern. I'm going to change the brightness, the contrast, and kind of mess around with some stuff. Maybe set this to rocky. Another thing I also did was I added a find edges. So I'm going to go to effects and presets, find edges, and then I'm going to apply that to it. And you can see it's a little bit too dense, so let's change the scale. And you can see I can get have a lot of fun in here just by messing around with just different parameters. I'm just playing around with the contrast. The complexity does some interesting stuff too. So the less complex the fractal noise is, the more simple it becomes. But then if I turn up the complexity, look how much detail starts popping up. I actually think we should use this as a bump map. Then we get like little etchings on the desk. So let's go to material M3. We're going to go down to bump map and we're going to load in the Holodesk base color. I'm actually going to duplicate this and call this Holodesk bump map. And that's a command or control D to duplicate. And then go to Geo. We're going to go to bump map type. We're going to make it a grayscale height map because this is all gray and there's no normal base like a normal map. We're going to say bump map. It's going to be the bump map layer we just made, effects and masks. Let's set the base color map to none just so we get a clean image where we can just see the bump map. So I'm going to go into the bump map and just kind of invert this, see if that kind of changes. That looks a little cooler to me. And let's try just messing around with the scale so we can kind of get this to look kind of nice. Play around with the brightness, contrast, see what happens here. Okay, so the darker it is, the less we can see it. Turn down the contrast so it's a little more subtle. Yeah, there we go. Okay, one thing we're going to want to do is make sure the roughness of the Holodesk is turned up all the way to 100. Remember, it's made out of stone. Another thing I'm going to want to do is I'm actually going to create another texture for the base color. So I'm going to go connect to the base color map. And then right now it's going to go black because the layer is it's a black solid. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a fractal noise. So let's add a fractal noise onto the base color map. And now you can see that fractal noise is now texturing the Holodesk. So let's see, let's just start playing around with the contrast here. I'm just trying to look for kind of a weathered stone kind of look here. That looks good. Okay, let's move on. Okay, let's see what's behind material number 4. Okay, this is the screen. Okay, so what we're going to do here is we are going to first turn down the roughness because we want it to be really shiny. It's like a glass screen. We're going to turn up the metalness, and now it's like a shiny reflective metal screen. We are now going to put something on the contents of the screen. So we're going to go ahead and create a new solid, and we're going to call this screen elements. And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to pre-compose this because I like having this in a different composition. It's called a screen elements comp. Move all attributes into new composition. This is going to be where we put all the stuff that's going to go on the screen. I'm going to go ahead and go to Geo, and we're going to go to emission color map, and we're going to say screen elements comp. So now if we double click on screen elements comp, we can get inside what's going to be the contents of the screen. Let's just go ahead and just type something silly. Amazing. Look at that. It's on the screen. Let's just see what happens on the, okay. Well, first off, we got to hide it. Geo screen elements. Ah, okay. We need to change the, emission color to white and then it will show up. So now whatever we put in here, will show up on the screen. You'll notice that on the left side of the comp, it kind of maps the left image on the screen. And on the right side of the comp, it maps to the right computer screen. This is intentional. I UV mapped the left side of the texture to go to this side of the screen and the right side to this one. I did this because we only have 5 materials in Geo, so it's just about being efficient. Okay, let's create some screen elements. And what better way to do that than if we go to Red Giant Motion Graphics, HUD components, yeah, that's right. If you drag on HUD components onto a solid, you can then get a library of a variety of different really cool HUD elements. Let's go ahead and check this out. We got echoes, we got blinking markers. We don't know what they mean, but they must be blinking to something. All sorts of good stuff. Let's do this XYZ grid. Now let's put this over to the left. Oh, okay. Let's go to element 1, go to transforms. We're gonna move it over to the left side. We're also gonna scale it up a little bit. Yeah, look at that. It appears on the left side of the screen. Okay, one thing, it's not moving. We gotta go to Geo and we're gonna go ahead and check animated textures right at the top next to materials. Very important to check that box. And now, look at that. It starts doing animated textures. Okay, let's create some HUD elements for the screen on the right. I'm going to go ahead and create another new solid for that one. We'll call it HUD Elements 2, the sequel. Then we're going to drag HUD components onto that one. Okay, cool. Let's go choose presets and let's go shopping for a little bit. Okay, let's see here. Oh, grid dots. Let's do grid dots. Looks like it's scanning for something. Go to element number 1, transforms. We're going to move this around, scale it up. Yeah, look at that. Looks like it's got some scanning stuff. Okay, I'm going to move it over just a little bit. Okay, that's looking good. Okay, let's go move on to the spaceship itself. Material 5. Okay, so let's change the color, make sure this is what we're looking at here. Okay, awesome. So for material 5, I definitely want it to be a spaceship metal. So I'm going to go ahead and turn up the metalness. Okay, set the metallic to 100. Now it looks all shiny and metallic. However, it looks way too smooth. So we're going to start by messing around with the roughness texture. I'm going to right click new solid and I'm going to call this spaceship metal roughness. And right now it's going to be all black. I'm going to add some fractal noise. You get the idea here. And we are going to, I'm going to hide it real fast. And I'm going to go to Geo. I'm going to go to the roughness map. So big thing about the roughness map. Roughness map is where you do all your surface imperfection. That's like your scratches, all that good stuff. Okay, let's start messing around with the roughness here. I'm going to go ahead and mess around with the scale. I think I found a really cool effect if I scale it all the way down. It creates a lot of like micro roughness elements where there's like slightly shiny parts and then slightly not so shiny parts. We can kind of dial this in with the contrast, but you can see if I turn it all the way down and make it dark, everything becomes chrome. But if I make it brighter, a more wider value, kind of the metal gets kind of worn out a little bit. One thing we can also do is we can use the roughness map to also drive the bump map. That can also do some really interesting stuff. We're gonna go to Geo, go to bump map, set it to grayscale height map, and set it to the metal roughness. And we'll do source effects, source and mask. It's gonna look a little crazy. So we're gonna turn down the bump map. Wait till it's something not so crazy. And now all we gotta do is choose the color of our spaceship, and our spaceship's pretty much wrapped up. Like maybe I'd choose like a dark blue or a dark gray. Yeah, like a dark grayish blue. That looks kind of cool. If you're Batman, you go full darkness, you know, but I'm gonna go for more of a darkish blue. The last thing is we didn't really talk about lighting, but underneath environment, you can adjust the sun intensity. You can adjust like the lighting. There's also a refraction and environment map. So you see these like reflections that's coming from an environment map. If we go to choose map, there's actually a bunch of really cool maps built into Geo. And look at that. There's one called Nebula. Oh, it's perfect. I'll go ahead and hit that. And look at that. It just looks like a really cool nebula, and I can adjust it, and wow, look at that. That looks really cool. Like the refraction map is what's creating that white softbox. I'm gonna hit custom and that will get that back to normal. And now look at this, we've made like an interior. If we want to really quickly make like a new white solid, so make it white, call it stars, add a starburst, and then put that behind the ship, and then turn down the size, set the speed to 0, and then maybe change the scatter. We now have kind of like this really cool space scene. Anyways, this has been fun. We've made a spaceship interior. We've learned how to make some procedural shaders all in After Effects. Next time on Intergalactic Forms, we're going to be creating a variety of exterior space effects. You won't want to miss it. I hope you've been having fun so far. Have a great rest of your day. My name is Blake Rizzo. Thanks for watching Intergalactic Forms.